What's up, dear students? Today we're going to be talking about membrane potentials and ion movement in cardiac conductive cells. Action potentials are considerably different between cardiac conductive cells and cardiac contractive cells. While sodium and potassium play essential roles, calcium is also critical for both types of cells. Unlike skeletal muscles and neurons, cardiac conductive cells do not have a stable resting potential. Conductive cells contain a series of sodium ion channels that allow a normal and slow influx of sodium ions that causes the membrane potential to rise slowly from an initial value of minus 60 millivolts up to about minus 40 millivolts. The resulting movement of sodium ions creates spontaneous depolarization or prepotential depolarization. It's very, very significant part. At this point, calcium ion channels open and calcium enters the cells, further depolarizing it at a more rapid rate until it reaches a value of approximately plus 5 millivolts. At this point, the calcium ion channels close and potassium channels open, allowing outflux of potassium and resulting in repolarization. When the membrane potential reaches approximately minus 60 millivolts, the potassium channels close and sodium channels open, and the prepotential phase begins again. This phenomenon explains the autorhythmicity properties of cardiac muscle. Membrane potentials and ion movement in cardiac contractile cells. There is a distinctly different electrical pattern involving the contractile cells. In this case, there is a rapid depolarization followed by a plateau phase and then repolarization. This phenomenon accounts for the long refractory periods required for the cardiac muscle cells to pump blood effectively before they are capable of firing for a second time. These cardiac myocytes normally do not initiate their own electrical potential, although they are capable of doing so, but rather wait for an impulse to reach them. Contractile cells demonstrate a much more stable resting phase than conductive cells at approximately minus 80 millivolts for cells in the atria and minus 90 millivolts for cells in the ventricles. Despite this initial difference, the other components of their action potentials are virtually identical. In both cases, when stimulated by an action potential, voltage-gated channels rapidly open, beginning the positive feedback mechanism of depolarization. This rapid influx of positively charged ions raises the membrane potential to approximately plus 30 millivolts, at which point the sodium channels close. The rapid depolarization period typically lasts 3 to 5 milliseconds. Depolarization is followed by the plateau phase, in which membrane potential declines relatively slowly. This is due in large part to the opening of the slow calcium channels, allowing calcium to enter the cells, while few potassium channels are open, allowing potassium to exit the cell. The relatively long plateau phase lasts approximately 175 milliseconds. Once the membrane potential reaches approximately zero, the calcium channels close and potassium channels open, allowing potassium to exit the cell. The repolarization lasts approximately 75 milliseconds. The entire event lasts between 250 and 300 milliseconds. The absolute refractory period for cardiac contractile muscle lasts approximately 200 milliseconds, and the relative refractory period lasts approximately 50 milliseconds, for a total of 250 milliseconds. This extended period is critical since the heart muscle must contract to pump blood effectively and the contraction must follow the electrical events. Without extended refractory periods, premature contractions would occur in the heart and would not be compatible with life. Calcium ions. Calcium ions play two critical roles in the physiology of cardiac muscle. Their influx through slow calcium channels accounts for the prolonged plateau phase and absolute refractory period that enable cardiac muscle to function properly. Calcium ions also combine with the regulatory protein troponin in the troponin-tropomyosin complex. This complex removes the inhibition that prevents the heads of the myosin molecules from forming cross-bridge mechanisms with the active sites on actin that provide the power stroke of contraction. This mechanism is virtually identical to that of skeletal muscle. Approximately 20% of the calcium required for contraction is supplied by the influx of calcium during the plateau phase. The remaining calcium for contraction is released from storage in the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Comparative rates of conduction system firing. The pattern of prepotential or spontaneous depolarization followed by rapid depolarization and repolarization just described are seen in the sinoatrial node and a few other conductive cells in the heart. Since the sinoatrial node is the pacemaker, it reaches threshold faster than any other components of the conduction system. It will initiate the impulses spreading to the other conducting cells. The sinoatrial node, without nervous or endocrine control, would initiate a heart impulse approximately from 80 to 100 times per minute. Although each component of the conduction system is capable of generating its own impulse, the rate progressively slows as you proceed from the sinoatrial node to the Purkinje fibers. Without the sinoatrial node, the atrioventricular node would generate a heart rate of 40 to 60 beats per minute. If the atrioventricular node were blocked, the atrioventricular bundle would fire at a rate of approximately 30 to 40 impulses per minute. The bundle branches would have an inherent rate of 20 to 30 impulses per minute, and the Purkinje fibers would fire at 15 to 20 impulses per minute. While a few exceptionally trained aerobic athletes demonstrate resting heart rates in the range of 30 to 40 beats per minute, for most individuals, rates lower than 50 beats per minute would indicate a condition called bradycardia. Depending upon the specific individual, as rates fall much below this level, the heart would be unable to maintain adequate flow of blood to vital tissues initially, resulting in decreasing loss of function across the systems, unconsciousness, and ultimately death. That's it, dear students. Please subscribe to my channel, put your comments in the comment section, give me your likes. Goodbye, see you.